districts.
Let us consider a matrix A of m cross n. In general, when we compute the left inverse or the right inverse, we will always consider that the two matrices, say if you have A and B, the product of them will not be equivalent to B into A. So, for left inverse, let us assume a matrix X to be the left inverse, and this matrix X will be the left inverse of A if X into A is equal to I. That is, A is left invertible if it has at least one left inverse. In similar terms, let us see what is right inverse. So again, in this case, let me consider X to be the right inverse of a matrix A if A into X is equal to I. That is, A is right invertible if it has at least one right inverse. So let us solve few problems on this and see how we can compute the left and the right inverse if a matrix A is given to us. So first one, first numerical, find the left inverse of A equals 1 minus 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. So to solve this, let us assume a matrix L that exists, and we need to consider the elements of this matrix in such a way that we can multiply it with the matrix A. And since this is a 3 cross 2 matrix, make sure that you have a 2 cross 3 matrix so that you can multiply. So this would be 2 cross 3, and this would be A, which is a 3 cross 2 matrix. So let me assume A, B, C, D, E, F, which is a 2 cross 3 matrix. So here we have assumed L to be equal to A, B, C, D, E, F. So our condition in order to determine the left inverse is L into A is equal to I. So let me write the matrix A, B, C, D, E, F. This is multiplied with 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. So this is L, this is A. This is equivalent to the identity matrix. So this will be 1, 0, 0, 1. So first check whether you are getting the same result. So if you have here L, this is a 2 cross 3 matrix. You are multiplying it with A, which is a 3 cross 2 matrix. And you are getting an identity matrix, which is equal to 2 cross 2. So cross multiply. First, what we'll be do is, we will multiply the first row of matrix L with both the columns of matrix A in order to obtain the equations. So I'm getting this as A plus B plus 2C equal to 1. So this is on multiplying ABC with the first column. So let me name this as equation 1. Second one is minus A plus B plus 3C equal to 0. This is my second equation obtained on multiplying ABC with the second column. Let us obtain the result. So if I'm going to add this, I get this as 2B plus 5C equal to 1. the value of b can be obtained as 1 minus 5c by 2 and a is equal to 1 plus c by 2, right? So this is my equation for ABC, or the relationship between ABC, that is obtained from multiplying the first row with the two columns of A. Let us see what happens if I'm going to multiply the second row. So on multiplying with the second row, I get the equations as D plus E plus 2F equal to 0. What I'm doing is I'm multiplying D with the first column of A and then equating it to the element which it corresponds to. Okay, so I'm getting this on multiplying with this to be equal to 0, and the second one minus D plus E plus 3F is equal to this particular element, that is equal to 1. So let me name these equations as 3 and 4. On solving these equations, I get it as 2e plus 5f equal to 1. Let us rearrange this. E is equal to minus 5f by 2. And d is equal to minus 1 plus f by 2. If you see these two equations, equation of the number capital I and this Roman number 1 and Roman number 2, what you observe is that these equations have been rearranged as per our need. So you can do the rearrangement as in the way you wish. So what if you see here is that in A and B is that we have a term C. So we can assume the value of C and then find out what B and A is. Similarly, in these two, F is the one which is common. So we can assume the value of F and determine what is D and E. So let us try the various possibilities that we can obtain. So say I assume the value of C to be equal to 0 and F to be equal to 0. Then I get the matrix as L to be equal to. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to obtain the values for A, B and C. I have assumed C to be equal to 0. So A will be equal to half, B will be equal to half, C I've assumed as 0. And in the second equation, I've assumed F to be equal to 0. So I'm getting this as minus half, half and 0. So this is one possibility. You can have n number of possibilities. That means we can have infinitely many inverses depending on what values you choose for C and F in this particular case. Let's go to the second problem. So in the second problem, we have to compute the right inverse of A, and the matrix is given to us, which is a 3 cross 3 matrix. We will assume the right matrix to be 2 cross 3. That is because when we multiply these two, right, we should be getting an identity matrix. So this is a 3 cross 2. We are multiplying it with 2 cross 3. These two should be the same. And the identity matrix that we'll obtain is a 3 cross 3 matrix. So let us write this. So A is the matrix. The inverse will be written as X, Y, Z, U, V, W. This is supposed to be a 3 cross 3 matrix. So 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So now let us multiply each row with every column and obtain the various set of equations that we get. So we have X minus U equal to 1. X plus u equal to 0, 2x plus 3u equal to 0, y minus v is equal to 0, y plus v is equal to 1, 2y plus 3v equal to 0, z minus w is equal to 0, z plus w is equal to 0 to z plus 3w is equal to 1. Now if you look at all these equations, right, and if you try to solve these equations, we do not get any result because these equations are not solvable. So basically these system of equations are inconsistent. So we say it is inconsistent only when we do not obtain a solution set. Since there is no possible way in which we can obtain a solution set, we say that no right inverse exists. So if you would have observed the problem that was given to you, that is the matrix A, is the same. So in this problem, we were able to obtain a left inverse for a matrix A, but not a right inverse for the matrix A. Thank you.